Hi, welcome to Stars Meet Heroes. I'm really, really happy and pleased that Ms. Manjari Fadnis could join us today and spend her precious time with us, talking to our young residents and doctors fighting the good fight of the COVID war. And it's very, very kind and sweet of her to give us some time so that we can think about something else and apart from COVID and have some fun. Manjari, welcome.
It is my pleasure, in fact, to actually meet all the young heroes out there, you know, fighting this whole battle. I'm so proud of you guys.
Thank you so much. So you know what? I'm going to give it over to you and these heroes, and I will ask these doctors to start saying hello to you one by one. I think we'll start with Prachi. Prachi, you want to say hi to Manjari and tell us who you are and where you're from?
Hello.
Hi, Prachi.
So we have two Prachi.
Yes. Should I start, ma'am? Rukshida,
yes.
Ma'am?
Yes, start.
Okay. Hello, hi, Manjari.
Hi.
Hi, this is Dr. Prachi Birangane. I am a pediatric resident, junior resident, second year resident in Nair Hospital. I am presently working, Nair is totally converted into COVID hospital. So we are presently working for pediatric patient and neonates, like less than 12 years, bachus in Nair Hospital.
Okay. Hi, Prachi.
Hi.
The two Prachis I heard, right?
Yeah. Okay, I am the second one. Can you hear me? All right.
I can hear you.
Yeah, I'm Dr. Prachi Bodke. I'm currently JR1, junior resident doctor in dermatology department in JJ Hospital, Mumbai.
Okay.
I'm from Pune, yeah.
Wow,
hi, Manjari, ma'am.
She's also a dermatologist. She doesn't live here, she lives in London. But
okay.
Yeah, I do have doctors in my family also, by the way.
Nice.
Well, Manjari, just for you, we also have doctors who are army doctors, and we have three majors just for you. So I think that the majors say hello one by one.
Good evening, okay, Manjari. Hi, Ankit.
Hi.
Good evening, Manjari. I am Major Amresh from Air Force Medical College, Pune, ma'am.
Oh, lovely. My dad's in the army, by the way. I don't know if you guys know that.
Yeah.
Yes, we are aware only through the Wikipedia, ma'am. But yes, it's a very good feeling that, lads from army, they are doing so good. I am Major Ankit Dangi, and I am a final year resident psychiatry at Armed Forces Medical College, Pune.
Wow.
Yes, we are very pleased to be here with you right now.
I'm pleased to be here with all of you. Yeah. In fact, I must tell you, I wanted to study not psychiatry, but psychology. I mean, like, you know, I mean, not the medical part of it, but I wanted to study it so much. But I got my first film after my 12th, so I couldn't continue. Hi,
Manjari. This is Major Markande Sharma. I'm resident psychiatry second year. Looking at you in the Wikipedia, I got to know that you want to become a psychological counselor.
Is that there in the Wikipedia?
Not that in the Wikipedia, it was somewhere in the videos which you told that.
I know. In fact, I've been using my entire lockdown time. I had this psychology book with me the BA psychology book with me, which I could never study because I got my first film after 12. So, but I had saved the book. I was like, one day I'm going to sit and study. I mean, I was, you know, one of the nerds in school. Like, I always wanted to, like, you know, become a, like, also a doctor. But, you know, I got scared. I must tell you, I got very scared. The whole idea of, in Munna Bhai MBBS, like, how they show you, like, you know, the you have to work with the dead bodies and everything. Like, you know, I mean, like, operate on them to learn. So how did you guys react to it? Please tell me, like, you know, when you guys went to med school, all of you. Tell me how your first experience.
I would like to share my experience.
Yes, tell me.
Okay, so in first year when we were asked to go to the dissection, or like honestly speaking, I wasn't accustomed to the smell of the formalin. And it took me a long time to get accustomed to it. And at that time, I decided that surgery won't be my side. I would rather go for MD.
Right. Did anybody faint?
Many of my friends fainted, but I fortunately did not faint.
And were they all teased after that? Like, I'm sure everybody teased them all their college life after that. Me?
Not really.
So we're all very nice.
They do become sort of stories for the rest of the college life. Yes.
Sorry?
Yes, they do become stories for the rest of the college life and even after also. So yes, we had people.
Was that your experience? Which is why you're like, yes, they did teach. They did tease us.
I didn't, but yes, I had friends and then we used to tease them. There were people who fainted in the OT also. So yes, it does happen. But then yes, people get used to it. It's a training. Yes, that's it.
Wow, I just wish
we have a lot of more people. Whether you told us your experience, but you didn't tell us your name.
Yeah, sorry. Hi, Manjiri. Hi, Rukshida ma'am. And hi, everyone. I'm Dr. Vaidehi. And I'm a resident in Department of Community Medicine, JJ Hospital.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Same here. I'm very glad to see you. I remember Jane Tu Ya Jane Na.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a very lovely movie.
Thank you so much.
And so I always tell the community medicine people that you should be very proud of yourself, but because you guys, we don't have polio. So
you guys are the real heroes right now. I mean, nobody else matters. Right now, the doctors are the big heroes. Like, all of us are extremely, extremely proud of you guys. Are you guys on the forefront?
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
How are your family members? Like, how they, like, are they all right?
Yes, ma'am. I would like to share that point, actually. Yeah. Our family members are all right, but they are like, actually, I'm from Solapur. So they are, my parents are like, they're like always worried, like, you work with the always with positive patients and how are there, where your PPEs don't, like, for even a single minute, don't remove your N95 mask and how you are, like, it is really actually scary for them to, because they are just, they are saying that we are afraid of going out of house. People are afraid of going out of house and you are directly communicating with those people, you are working there. So actually it is kind of, they are like calling, we want to see you in PPE. They are calling just like 4 to 5 times in a day. How are you? How are you eating? Please eat good food, maintain your immunity. So especially to tackle mothers these days is like, yeah, because they are like, it is difficult for them to handle, but now they are also accustomed and it is nice when they tell to our relatives that we are proud of them, our daughter is working there for the patients, and it's a nice feeling overall.
That's amazing. Tell me something, tell me, like, what do you guys like to do apart from treating patients and apart from like medical stuff? Like, what are your hobbies? Like, what do you guys like to do otherwise?
I like singing. I sing mostly Rihanna song. I have extremely soft voice. I don't know. I like that lady.
And sing for us. Let's hear it from, like, we're going to come back to you. But I want to hear the other people also. Like, what do you guys otherwise do? But we're going to make you sing, okay? We have to make her sing. Huh?
Pakka, pakka.
Yeah.
Radhika, you want to say hi?
Yeah. Hi. Actually, my network connectivity got a little slow. Hi Manjiri, this is Dr. Radhika. I'm working as a second year resident anesthesia in Sion Hospital, Mumbai. And I would like to say I have watched Janet. We are Janet almost 50 times till date.
Yeah, more than that.
Yeah. Yeah, seriously. I watched it so many times. It's my favorite film. And I love you in that film.
Thank you so much. So what do you do apart from medical and everything?
Yeah, so apart from working, I like reading crime novels, watching crime shows, and I like to watch everything related to crime and psycho thrillers and all.
Have you had any experience where you've had to deal with crime?
No. Thankfully, no. No. Thankfully, no such experience. But I would like to, actually.
Satyanash, what is this? She wants a crime to happen so that she treats me. What is this? The moment somebody said second year, third year, you know, it reminds me of Grey's Anatomy. How many of y'all have watched Grey's Anatomy out here?
Big fan.
Like, continuously, like, watching it. Like, I'm the 8th season right now.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, 8th season. 7th, end of a 7th season.
Have the others also seen it?
I've seen it. I don't know about the others. Has anybody seen Grey's Anatomy? Yeah, so Manjari, we are doctors. So for most of our lives, we live under a rock because all we do is breathe and study and that's it. So if we are not up to the current status, yeah, you're going to have to just accept the fact that we're very hardworking doctors.
Very good. Okay, so we have one singer here. Do we have a dancer here? Do we have an actor here? Tell me.
I don't know, Panini. He seems to have a lot of books. So I'm not sure whether that's for sure, whether he's actually studying that much. But maybe he dances. Panini, do you dance?
No, I am not really good at dance. And these are not my books, actually. I'm at uncle's place right now.
So he's very strategically chosen that spot. Just to show I'm so intelligent. I'm a doctor. I study so much.
This is actually my uncle's place in Thane right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
It looks lovely. You know, when we were talking about Grey's Anatomy, I do have like not a funny thing to share, but there was this young girl who had seen a few episodes of Grey's Anatomy, and she came to me. She was very upset, and I was like, "Okay, what's going on, bacha?" And she said, "I thought that I want to grow up and be a doctor." So I was like, "Okay, that's a good idea. What happened?" So she said, "No, then I saw Grey's Anatomy, and I don't want to sleep with so many people."
Oh my god.
No, I know, so unrealistic, right? It's like, it's just like it's so much of incest. I like watching it. I really enjoy it.
At least that part we can attribute to the Western side, not.
So you guys must be getting hit on by your patients and all that, no? All these pretty girls and good-looking doctors and everything. All these, all of you out here, do you all get like some do some patients flirt with you?
Who's gonna say yes to that? I know I have been.
It sometimes does happen, but then we are taught boundaries. You know, that's a part of our medical teaching. We are used to it, sort of.
So what happens if you actually like start liking your patient?
No, then you have to course correct, right?
Had this experience.
You have to course correct. You seek advice, and then maybe you transfer your patient to someone else. I think that's
the girl who was
what we generally call.
Someone else was really laughing. Beach mein, I saw that girl. Where is she?
Devika? Or Rashmi?
Laughing when she was like, when we were talking about it. She has something to share. Maybe some
girl. I think.
Okay, you guys are telling your hobbies, by the way. Coming back to that. What else do you guys do apart from studying and treating patients and everything?
I like cooking. And like everyone, lockdown has really extracted my talent from me. Like I can cook also. Not just I can do the Maggi and omelette or something, but I can cook more than that, I feel. So I've been tried making Manchurian, Pav Bhaji, and biryani, of course, with my friends. Then I'm working on that now, so I should be a good cook.
Very good. I think this lockdown is gonna come out with some really amazing master chefs, like friends like posting some really outstanding stuff. Some friends of mine who are guys who haven't even boiled an egg in their life, they have been cooking some really interesting stuff. What are the boys out here?
Panini is raising his hand, so he's been cooking apparently.
Yeah, last month I've been cooking a lot actually.
What have you learned?
Actually, in reality, my hobby is traveling, but thanks to this lockdown, I've not been able to do anything traveling or trekking. So while I was at home, I learned cooking and I've done pretty good dishes actually.
Right?
Yeah, I've done many non-veg dishes such as chicken korma, then I've done chicken biryani, even I've done one big dish. One chicken ogretin, and it was really good actually.
Awesome.
Till 2 months back, I couldn't even boil an egg, but now I'm doing a few things.
That's nice, wonderful. Rashmi is the quiet one, but we're going to see whether we can ask her to say hello to us.
Hi everyone, this is Rashmi. Rashmi Biradar from JJ Medical College. I'm pursuing dermatology first year.
Lovely.
I'm from Karnataka.
Okay. Hi.
Hi. Hi.
So what do you do apart from
Apart from studying and all, I like to cook. and I like to read novels.
Awesome. Do you get time to read novels?
Now I'm getting time to read.
Okay.
In this lockdown.
Good. Let's make that girl sing. Where is she?
Yeah, actually.
Yes, come on. Let's try singing.
Okay, should I? Let me clear. I'm not that good actually. I'm not at all, but big fan of Rihanna. I just try to sing her in acoustic versions. So I'll sing Diamonds from Rihanna's Diamonds.
I love that song.
Should I start? I'm getting nervous. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Fine line in a beautiful sea, I choose to be happy. You and I, black diamonds in the sky. You're the shooting star I see, a vision of ecstasy. When you are me, I'm alive. Yeah, diamonds in the sky. I knew that would become fun right away. Oh, right away. At first sight, I felt the energy of sunrise. I saw the life in you eyes so shine bright. Tonight, you and I, we are beautiful like diamonds in the sky. I do I, so alive. We are beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. We are beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Thank you.
Yay! Awesome.
Very nice.
Wow.
Something, you guys.
You.
When you guys watched Munna Bhai MBBS,
yeah.
Did you want to try to do something out of the box? For your patients, like instead of just being like strict doctors, did you try to do something else, like maybe sing for your patient, or maybe like, you know, somebody who's like, you know, admitted in the hospital and getting bored? Did you guys do anything for them?
We tried the thing with the mama, not the hugging thing, but just we understood that they are so much irritated that they are cleaning the whole place day and night, and people kept walking on it because they are always irritated. Even if you come to hospital, even we come across that thing that they are so irritated, they are always angry. But out of that movie, we came to know that this could be the condition, and we should. And we personally, me started after that. I just started talk to them very nicely because I understood their age is more, their work is more, and equally as important that keeping the hospitals clean. So yes. That I really learned from that movie.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Ma'am, in our wards, hospital wards.
Your internet.
Hello?
Yeah.
She's paused. Yeah.
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Devika, go ahead.
Yeah. So ma'am, in our hospital wards, what we usually do is that on Sundays, we usually arrange for an antakshari between the patients. Yeah, so it's really nice, and sometimes we even, for the fun of it, play some music on the speaker, so whoever wants to dance comes up and starts dancing. So I think it's not only a, like, you know, refreshing thing for them, but for us also. It's a very good moment to actually see them so happy.
Yeah. Wow, that's so amazing. I can't imagine that. Like, that's so amazing, Rukshida.
Yes. And you know, because like how you guys, when you guys are in a shoot, and especially when you're outdoor and you guys become a family, So we understand that our patients are kind of a family, because, you know, their treatment, we're all in it together. So and these kids are doing like such a wonderful job, and the more said, the less it is for them, really, honestly speaking. Though I would really like to know from the AFMC people if they're allowed to play Antakshari in their hospital.
Yeah. Ma'am, you all discipline and all that.
Not possible, ma'am.
Not possible?
Ma'am, you know, from army background, you heard word, bhoot bana diya jayega. Bhoot bana denge.
But I would like to say, ma'am, like we are psychiatrists, so we have chronic wards. Patients stay there for a lot longer period of time compared to other wards. So we do have facilities for recreation, like we provide them indoor games facilities. And yes, if you know they indulge in playing cards and all, and if required, maybe though not an organized thing, but at their own level, if they do it, I don't think that's a problem. They may do it.
You guys participate.
No, that becomes a little difficult because they are men and, you know, there's a bit of hierarchy in armed forces. So that thing has to be considered. So that becomes a little difficult, you know, but no, it's not something which is stopped. It is rather encouraged if they want to do it amongst themselves.
Okay, amazing. At least, I mean, I'm sure y'all must be wishing like, oh, I wish we could just take a break and just join them in their games and their fun time, right?
But once we get frustrated with our work, we would like to play. We used to play like carom board cards with them. So it's quite interesting. We got to know that we are very much good in this carom board.
Oh.
One thing I would like to tell in this lockdown, I have completed my sleep like anything. I slept like anything.
Ma'am, I want to ask one question. How was your experience with army?
My army experience was outstanding. I don't think any child can get a better upbringing than like her dad or his dad being in the army. Because I think every 3 years, you know the drill. Every 3 years, we would get posted to different places. So, matlab, I have stayed in Shimla, Jammu, Delhi, Pune, Bombay. Like every three years, I've kept moving in different places. It was amazing meeting different kind of people. And the army people are like, they're like a family. Like every regiment, every unit. Isn't it? Correct me if I'm wrong. We all become like a family. We have this core days happening. Full on must be happening with everyone. So I think it's amazing. Army life is the best.
Very true.
So I know we've asked like very little time from you, so we don't really want to overstep our boundaries. And I do wanted to ask, I think I see a cat.
I have two cats. Wait. Sita, let me just introduce you to my cat. Wait, hold on. Say hi.
Hi.
Hi, Simba.
Hi.
Say hi. He normally talks when he's alone with me. He always
replies. So cute.
You don't want to stay? Okay. Say bye.
Bye.
Say bye. No? Okay. Yeah, but one of them is upstairs sitting on my study table.
I have a request for you.
Yes.
Okay, so I know you are a very good singer and you have a lovely voice. Apart from us, we are not that good at it as much you are good at it. So we would request you to please a few words. Any song would do.
Any song?
Yeah, please, yeah.
Which song do you guys like?
Any which you love to sing, which you would love
from
to
Jaane
sing.
From Jaane Tu, we could request from Jaane Tu, Kahi To.
Okay, fine. That's it. Yeah. So it is.
Yeah.
Kahi To, Hogi Wo, Duniya Jahan Tu Mere Paas Hai. Join me. Jahan main jahan tu aur jahan bas
tere mere jaisa saath hai.
Hoti jahan
meri palkon ki kirno mein.
Lori jahan jaan सुने तेरे आँखों में जाने ना
कहाँ वो दुनिया है,
जाने ना वो है भी या नहीं, जहाँ मेरी जिंदगी मुझसे इतनी खफा नहीं।
Very lovely.
Yeah, very lovely.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So the reason I didn't join in because my brother offers to pay me not to sing. And Manjari, we can't thank you enough. I know you've been very, very busy and you're preparing for a shoot that's going to happen right in your house. And because of the lockdown, you guys are innovating as well. So you want to quickly tell us, what have you been doing today before we let you go? We have 2 minutes left.
What have I been doing today?
Yes.
Today, I've just been prepping for a film shoot of mine, which I'll be shooting from home. So, I mean, it's going to be a very different experience for me because I'll have to do everything by myself with the guidance of the director and the cinematographer over Zoom chat and the cues coming from my actors. So, from the Zoom. So it's going to be an exciting shoot and it's going to be a fun thing. So I was just working on that before.
So thank you so much. You guys, you've been so busy and I know our doctors have been busy as well. And you guys want to say a quick bye and a last message to her or to other people out there?
It was really nice, Manjari ma'am. Thank you. Thank you for your valuable time, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you so much for spending time with me. You guys have been much more busy than any one of us all put together last 3 months. So I just wish all of you to always be safe and sound. And keep doing the great work, guys. I'm so proud of all of you.
Thank you so much.
Lots of love.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, love you back.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks, Rukshida. Thanks for having me.
My pleasure.